For the first freeze frame video diary. Okay. That's right, folks. You at home, get a blank videotape.
Video calendar. Calendar.
Oh. Oh.
Video calendar.
And stick it into your VCR and press record when I tell you, okay. And you will have this
get
moment.
Get a video in there now, and this is January.
This is January's moment
okay,
of in posterior. Posterity. Yeah. Okay, Chris.
You ready?
Alan, ready?
Okay, you ready?
Oh,
January.
Medical.
January, you ready? Tell me when.
January, now! Freeze for 5 seconds.
3, 2, 1.
Woo! That's the January calendar.
February issue coming your
January
way soon.
On the way soon. And who are these from then?
Ow.
Ow. Tell us.
These are from Laura Grady, who sent these in, and she said she...
Hi, Laura.
Ow. She loves me.
Would you like a go?
Yeah. Thank you. Ready?
Okay,
so my mouth. Yeah, but my one, look, it's me hanging upside down by my anorak.
Wow.
It's there. And that's
no, I think Nicola. You put it on upside down.
That's all.
Oh, yeah! I actually had it on upside down, silly me, from Nicola Harvey from Kent.
Okay.
Thanks, Nicola!
Woo! And oh. Sue from Wardrobe gave me this hat.
Meeting. We have a meeting.
Meeting.
Do you think January works, maybe? Good idea?
Cool. I thought you were mate. Could we try it again?
We do another January.
No.
For the banana split.
Well.
Yeah, okay. Set your videos for January video calendar.
January the 2nd.
Okay, what? Okay, they're pressing the button.
Okay, get up, Chris.
Show us the secret club handshake that he has created.
I will be happy to, Flea. And now, fellas, here is the secret club handshake. May I ask for someone to assist me?
I'd be glad to, Roper.
Thank you, Bingo. Now, first we clasp hands, right hand. Then we clasp left hand. Now we... What? Look out there. Now, that's it. Hold it there. Now, watch it now, Bingo.
And that, folks, is the new secret club handshake. Oh, boy. Is there a Boy Scout in the audience who could untie knots? Boy, am I glad the puppy's in a good mood today.
Yes. He's feeling much better since the veterinarian came by yesterday.
How did puppy like the bench?
Delicious.
And for that pink MIDI system, and also here comes my phone now. Fantastic. What kind of phone is it today? Oh, it's Anthea Turner. Fantastic. So let's play Who's Watching Alice anyway, right here on The Big Breakfast, just before we meet Michaela Strachan and do all that kind of stuff. Who's on line one? Hello?
Hello.
Who's that?
Kathleen.
Okay, Kathleen, where are you calling from?
Broadstairs.
Nice to talk to you. How are you today?
Not too bad. I've got a bit of a cold.
Oh, a bit of a cold. Oh. Can you just give us a bit of a sniff on the telly now? Can you Can you do this? Can you do this? Let her have a go. Go on, Kathleen. No phlegm there, was there really? Okay. So we're looking for a famous person for that great pink MIDI system, and Jamie, here's the first clue from Jamie, the family of the week. Oh. Don't help him, don't help him, don't help him. Go on, Jamie, go on. Anyway, it's a blonde wig. What's the answer? Who do you think it is? A blonde wig. Gotta hurry.
Dolly Parton.
Pardon?
Dolly Parton.
Molly Parton? No, that's wrong, I'm afraid. Oh, Dolly Parton. Sorry, I thought you said Molly Parton. I was going to say her hair changes colour every day. Okay, line two, hello.
Hello?
Who's that?
Robert.
How are you, Rob?
Fine, thanks.
Okay, you sound like a bit of a serious hairy bloke to me. Okay, lighten up for heaven's sake. You're on television on Britain's Brightest Breakfast Show. Good morning from your television here. Okay, clue number two, Simon. Oh, if you could just turn the clue to the camera, it would help awfully. Okay, that's a smile. So we've got a blonde wig and a smile. Who do you think it could be?
Marilyn Monroe.
Marilyn Monroe, great guess, but yay! Wrong. Oh. That's all right, because you're a hairy bloke. Line three, hello.
Hello.
Who's that?
Hello.
Yes, I said hello. Who's that?
It's Anne from Nottingham.
How are you, Anne?
Fine, thank you.
Okay, got to rush on now. Got to be quick. Clue number three, Suzanne. Oh, it's just a red herring, I'm afraid. So we just got a smile still and a blonde wig.
Bette Lynn, Julie Goodyear.
That is good guess, but wrong again. Line four, hello. Who's that on washing line?
Hello, it's Glenn Bingham from Rochdale.
All right, how are you?
Not too bad.
Cool. Okay, clue number four. It's some sticky back plastic.
Sticky back plastic, rather.
Come on. Sticky black plastic. Back plastic. Gotta hurry you now. Come on. You don't know. Goodbye.
No.
Line five. Hello.
Hello, Chris.
Who's that?
It's Tony.
Okay, very easy now. Okay, Judy's got the last clue, and it's a Blue Peter badge, and the answer is... You don't know, do you?
No.
You don't know?
No.
It was Anthea Turner! See, that proves nobody knows who she is. Anyway, just before I go back inside, the question about the clip is, whose body is this? But remember, don't phone, it's just for fun. Okay, the question was about that clip. Who is this working out? And the Zig? Answer was... Zig?
What's the answer?
You locked the door for
a minute ago.
Yeah.
A lady.
By the name of?
She was in a swimming costume thing.
Oh,
Cindy Crawford.
Cindy Crawford is the answer.
And a lady.
Zig, that's your bit.
Okay.
Every day from now on, that's your bit.
Okay, throw me the guest microphone now.
We've got a guest coming.
Right.
The guest can't come in until Zag announces the guest.
Throw me the guest microphone,
Okay, today's guest on Starfile is...
Michaela Strachan.
Yes!
Michaela Strachan! She's on the big breakfast in the bathroom right now!
Val!
And the big question I've got for Michaela, should I wear the hair in the hat or outside?
I think that's very nice, but you do need an earring to go with it.
Michaela's come in to talk to us about...
Okay, Michaela Strachan and her unfeasibly large earrings.
Alan,
stay tuned,
I was doing a bit there and went all the way over there.
Put it on, don't panic!
Michaela's talking to us today about all her earrings,
and she hasn't got many.
No, only about 150 pairs.
She's only got these here, right? Okay.
Millions of earrings.
And these here. Wow. Okay, fantastic. You have your favourites though, Michaela, to show us now.
Well, actually, I've got some on my ears as well, which I thought was particularly appropriate for today.
Oh, these say I'm surrounded by idiots.
Hilarity galore.
Yes.
Michaela.
I'm trying to do an interview.
Michaela, I've seen you on TV.
I've seen you on TV.
Yeah, I've been on. And you know, I've been in Grange Hill as well. I've been in Grange Hill.
Ray
great question. Great interview.
No, I have.
Robin Day was good, yeah? He peaked on Robin Day on New Year's Eve, and after that, not a thing. He sort of went like this, and then down there. Okay, first earrings then, Michaela.
Well,
are you going to talk about these, or are you just going to hang them all?
No, I'm going to hang them up. No, these are particularly good ones, don't you think? These are one of the old favourites.
Okay.
I mean, those.
Thank you.
And
these. Oh, no, it's happened again! Turn off your television, please!
Oh, that's better. Okay.
My hair.
So, Michaela, why did you make earrings your trademark then?
Well, I thought Bette Lynch can't have all the earrings, you know, so I just... Actually, there are a pair of Bette Lynch ones somewhere in one of these books, but I can't find them.
Or Mrs. Harrison! She's our neighbour in number 14.
Oh, yeah.
She's got earrings.
Oh, right.
And a dog.
Sorry. I knew that the mistake was the repositioning of the guest. Zig is in prime position to do the interview, and of course you were always here.
I was always the man with the
cracking hat, by the way.
Mr. Alien Questionnaire, they called me down at the Alien Club.
Zig?
Yeah?
One question, please, Michaela, that makes some sense, please.
Okay, well, Michaela, personal hygiene is obviously of great importance in your job. What sort of hints can you pass on to big breakfast viewers?
I should say you should have a bath at least once a month.
There you go, you're
okay.
I like that question, the personal hygiene touch.
Always go for that. Whatever it is, go for the personal hygiene question. It's in the handbook. It is.
TV handbook.
Okay, so will you ever stop wearing earrings then? Do you feel like people will expect the earring wearing?
I think they probably do, actually.
But I saw you on television in a black cat suit about 6 months ago.
No.
I can't remember what it was on, and you were wearing earrings. Pardon?
Ow!
Did she do that?
No, that's what you do.
If you wear a black cat suit.
Ow!
In fact, if you're a cat, maybe. But you wear a black cat suit, and you sort of ditched the earrings for a day, and it was quite a nice... Look, I thought.
Was it a nice change for you, Chris?
Yeah.
Well, maybe especially for you, one day I won't wear them.
Because you're in pantomime at the moment. Do you wear your earrings in the panto?
I do, but actually they fall off every single night because I dance.
Well, why wear them then? Why wear them if they fall off?
Who else is with you?
Bobby Davro?
Yeah.
Hey, Nobby the Sheep.
Nobby the Sheep!
The Sheep that talk!
Yeah!
What a ridiculous idea that is!
He's good though, I like him!
Can't possibly be real.
Hi, Nobby!
Hi, Nobby the Sheep!
Hi, Nobby the Sheep!
Have your earrings ever caused any problems on the tent?
Only them falling off and getting. They do get stuck in cables quite a lot.
Do they?
Yeah, you know, you suddenly get attached to a camera.
If one got stuck in a cable and ripped your ear off, would the TV company be liable or would it be your fault for wearing earrings?
I think a bit of both, actually. There'd be a lot of.
But what would happen in court?
Well, who knows?
Zach, what do you think?
Let's pull his
head. We like your opinion.
Yeah, they're my
right now, to this address. Do the address now.
Address foul, foul, address
foul.
What would happen in court?
What would happen in court?
The big breakfast, two Kinder cookies, all four lot, the 3-3-2 and then.
And remember,
what would happen in court?
Callum Strachan, ear ripped off scandal thing.
Yeah.
Sun's headline, ear. Something's gone wrong. Something's gone wrong here. Okay. What would happen is... Anyway, that's about all for now. So remember, personal hygiene and earrings is where it's at as far as Michaela's concerned. And also, there's a sheep called Nobby comes into it somewhere.
Yeah.
All right, tomorrow...
Tell him.
Tomorrow, Junior Jukebox Journey, where we preview Not...
You messed it up.
Who wrote this?
Tomorrow we're going to show confidence, but tomorrow we're going to show your raps that you sent to us. Thank you, Michaela.
We're coming over to your house for lunch later on, okay?
And you're watching
the big breakfast.
The big breakfast.
Two pieces of wholemeal toast, spread with Marmite, no margarine, and a thin layer of peanut butter.
The big breakfast!
7:38 on the Big Breakfast. Now, we've got our Ghostbusters in here this morning, and we want to hear about your ghost.
Somebody sent in.
Oh, don't get all dramatic.